Good morning students, welcome back to Max class. Today we are going to continue the mathematical induction remaining problem. So what is mathematical induction? It is a method to prove the statement, right? So what are the steps to be followed for mathematical induction? First step is whatever the statement is given, you have to take it as P of n. Second step, you have to take n equal to 1. And you have to prove it is true. Next step, n equal to k, and we are going to assume that p of k is true. And the last step, we have to take p of k plus 1, and using p of k, we are going to prove p of k plus 1. Right? Have you all remembered? Okay. Now take your exercise, 8th problem. So take your exercise 2.5. 8th problem, and question, it is given that n into n plus 1 n plus 2 is divisible by 6 for all n in n. Okay, what is the question given here? N into n plus 1 n plus 2 is divisible by 6, correct? Okay, so what is your first statement? Let p of n implies n into n plus 1 n plus 2 is divisible by 6. Next, what we have to do? Let n equal to 1, correct? So let n equal to 1. So p of 1 implies, instead of n, what you have to substitute? 1. So 1 into 1 plus 1, 1 plus 2. What is the answer? 2. Here it is 3. 3 2s are 6, correct? 6 is divisible by 6, correct? Therefore, we can conclude that P of 1 is true, correct? P of 1 is true. What is your next step? We have to take n equal to k. Let n equal to k, correct? Okay, so now what we are going to take? P of k implies k into k plus 1. K plus 2 is divisible by 6. Correct? It's divisible by 6. So what we can conclude here? Assume that P of K is true. Assume that P of K is true. What is the last step? Let n equal to, okay, here we are saying that, I forgot that step. Here it is a statement which we can't do anything, okay? So we have to change the statement as a mathematical formulation, then only we can use it for p of k plus 1, correct? So we can take it this as k plus 1, k plus 2 equal to, the divisible of 6, no? So 6 into some constant. Okay, well, 6c. Now, what is the c? C is a constant. Now, we can take let n equal to k plus 1. Is that okay? It's okay. So, what we want to prove? We want to prove that p of k plus 1 is true. P of k plus 1 is true. So, what is P of K plus 1? Instead of N, what you are going to substitute? K plus 1. So this is K plus 1, K plus 1 plus 1, K plus 1 plus 2. Okay, again, if you rewrite this one, K plus 1, K plus 2, and 2 plus 1, 3. So K plus 3. Okay, so P, what we want to prove? P of K plus 1 equal to K plus 1, K plus 2, K plus 3. Is divisible by 6. Okay, so okay, we can consider. So we can take k plus 1, k plus 2, k plus 3. Okay, so we are considering the term k plus 1, k plus 2, k plus 3. So again, how can we rewrite this one? K plus 1 into, we can split this K plus 3. So we can take K plus 1 के प्लस टू इंटू के प्लस थ्री इंटू दिस टर्म थ्री इंटू के प्लस वन के प्लस टू वाई वी आर स्प्लिटिंग लाइक दिस इज टू गेट द आंसर दैट्स ऑल्सो हाउ वी स्प्लिटेड दिस टर्म के इंटू दिस टू टर्म्स थ्री इंटू दिस टू टर्म्स इज दैट ओके नाउ अगेन के प्लस वन के प्लस टू इंटू के दिस इज योर के टर्म सो इंस्टेड ऑफ दैट वी कैन टेक इट दैट एज थ्री सी प्लस द रिमाइनिंग टर्म विल बी थ्री इंटू के प्लस वन के प्लस टू नाउ ओके वा सो हियर इट इज अगेन सिक्स सी प्लस थ्री इंटू एंड हियर इफ यू सी दिस विल बी एन ईवन नंबर करेक्टा सो वट एवर नंबर इफ यू टेक हियर यू विल गेट अ ईवन नंबर प्लस वन इज योर ईवन नंबर सो दिस इज थ्री इंटू ईवन नंबर करेक्टा सो now any term into that is the 6 into any term it should be a divisible of 3 okay so again this we can take it as okay and here if you see if k is odd or even whatever number if you take k is odd or even which is divisible by your second term is always even number okay so now here we can conclude that p of k plus 1 is true whenever p of k is true what is the last step you have to conclude therefore by mathematical induction p of n is true for all n in n so mathematical induction you have to write fully okay so is that clear okay So now we can get into the next problem, 9th one. And your question it is given that 2 power n is greater than n for all n in n. This is your question. So directly we can get into the solution. What is your first step? Let P of n implies 2 power n greater than n. Okay, va. Next. Step 1 what we can take? Let n equal to 1. So if we take n equal to 1, p of 1 implies 2 power 1 is greater than 1, correct? 2 power 1 is 2. Is that 2 is greater than 1? Yes. Therefore, p of 1 is true. What is your next step? Let n equal to k. So p of k implies 2 power k greater than k that we are going to assume that so assume that what you are going to assume p of k is true next let n equal to k plus 1 correct so what we have to prove p of k plus 1 equal to 2 power k plus 1 greater than k plus 1 So let we can consider this 2 power k plus 1 term. So 2 power k plus 1, how can we write 2 power k into 2? Okay, va. So here we can take this 2 power k as k using the previous step. Okay, this is less than k into 2. This 2 power k using your previous term that is k term this can be taken as greater than k into 2 that is greater than 2k correct okay now look at here if since k is greater than 1 correct since k greater than 1 k plus k greater than 1 plus k correct in the k greater than 1 namba prove pannidom both side add by k so this step you will get correct so we can write this as 2k greater than 1 plus k correct okay so using this term we can write this is greater than k plus 1 that's all so 2k plus 1 is greater than k plus 1 therefore we can conclude that p of k plus 1 पी ऑफ के प्लस वन इज ट्रू व्हेन आवर पी ऑफ के इज ट्रू. एंड व्हाट इज द लास्ट स्टेप टू कंक्लूड? देयरफॉर बाय मैथमेटिकल इंडक्शन पी ऑफ एन इज ट्रू फॉर ऑल एन इन एन. दैट्स ऑल. नेक्स्ट टॉपिक बाइनोमियल थ्योरम. सो व्हाट इज मीन बाय बाइनोमियल? व्हाट इज मीन बाय दिस बाइनोमियल? एन अलजेब्रिक सम ऑफ एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ सम और डिफरेंस ऑफ टू टर्म्स. सो एदावदु ओरु टू टर्म्स एडुपोम अदोडिय सम और डिफरेंस इज कॉल्ड बाइनोमियल. ओकेवा? सो हियर फॉर एन एग्जांपल ऑफ बाइनोमियल इज x plus y. So x one term, y one term, it is a combination of sum, correct? So this is one binomial, and it may be x plus 1 by x the whole power 5. This is also a binomial theorem. X is one variable here, 1 by x is one variable, and this is also one binomial. So what is mean by binomial? An algebraic expression of sum or difference of two terms is called binomial. Okay, ma. Now, what is this binomial theorem? Okay, have you studied a plus b the whole square formula? Yes, we know a plus b the whole square formula. We know a plus b the whole cube formula. Yes, we know. Is it possible to find a plus b power 10? Can you able to simplify this a plus b power 10? No, we don't have direct formula for this, right? So to evaluate the binomial theorem or binomial expression, when the power is more than 3, we can use the binomial theorem. So eppa namba binomial theorem use pannalam? When the power is higher, when the power is higher, then we can use this binomial theorem. Okay, va? So 2 and 3 and all directly you can use a formula, but for 10 you can't use a formula. For that purpose we used this binomial theorem. Okay, and what is your binomial theorem? X plus a power n. This is a format. X plus a power n is your binomial theorem. Okay, when n is greater than 3. Okay, so what is this x plus a power n formula? This is what you have to learn. So x plus a power n formula is n c naught x power n a power 0 plus n c 1 x power n minus 1 a power 1 plus n c 2 x power n minus 2 a power 2 etc. And the last term will be n c r x power n minus r a power r. This is okay, and this is a middle term, and again your last term will be plus n c n x power 0 a power n is your binomial expansion. Is your binomial expansion. So again tell me, if the power is higher, what theorem we are going to use? Binomial theorem. So what is that binomial theorem formula? X plus a power n. So what is x plus a power n formula? N c naught x power n a power 0 plus n c 1 x power n minus 1 a power 1 plus n c 2 x power n minus 2 a power 2 etc. And the last term will be n c n x power 0 a power n. Is that clear why we are using this binomial theorem? Yes, when the power is higher we can use this formula to evaluate the given expression. Is that okay? Okay, now this is a what is that note you have to know with that. So if the number of x plus a power n is there. So how many terms will be there? Terms now 1, 2, 3, etc. like that, correct? For an example, if a plus b the whole square. So what is a plus b the whole square? A square plus b square plus 2ab, correct? Now, a plus b the whole square, kevlo term 3 term. Appo inge power 2 arunda 3 terms varu. Power 3 arunda 4 terms varu. Power 5 arunda 6 terms varu. So what is the general formula? If we have x plus a power n, then we will get n plus 1 terms. Is that okay? Yes. Next. So here we can write n c r is equal to n c n minus r, we can write down. Okay, why we are using this? To make the calculation simple, that's all. Okay, next one is sum of coefficients, or sum of coefficients in the expansion 1 plus x power n is equal to, that is sum of coefficients of x power 1 plus x power n is equal to 2 power n. So sum of coefficient of x power x plus 1 power n can be taken as 2 power n. Okay, next, your term formula. This is your term formula and this is your important one. So what is term formula? Is tr plus 1 is equal to n cr x power n minus r a power r. So what is this term meaning? Is suppose if in this expansion a plus b power 10, how many terms will be there? 11 terms will be there. So 11 terms la I want to find out the fifth term oda answer enna va irukum appadina, I can use this formula, this term formula, to find out the value of a power 5. Okay, so what is term formula? Formula T R plus 1 is equal to N C R X power N minus R A power R. Is that clear? So next formula, find the middle term of X plus A power N. So what is this middle term? Suppose if there are 7 terms will be there. So 7 terms la, what will be your middle term? 4th term. Okay, wa? So if middle term is even, then formula for finding middle term is t power n by 2 plus 1. If middle term is odd, that is n term is odd, then the two middle terms are tn plus 1 by 2, tn plus 3 by 2. Okay, so again one more time I'll tell you what is this middle term is. After finding the expansion, and the expansion oda middle la enna term irukku abdini we are going to find out. So if n is odd, middle term is tn by 2 plus 1. If n is if this is even, if n is odd, then the two middle terms are tn plus 1 by 2, tn plus 3 by 2. Okay, wow. Again, this is another two formulas is there. Actually, what is binomial theorem formula? X plus a power n, correct? Okay, instead of a, if there is 1, so 1 plus x power n. So what is 1 plus x power n? As like the formula only, but instead of a, what we are going to substitute? 1. So what is 1 plus x power n formula? 1 plus n c 1 into x plus n c 2 into x square plus etc. up to n c n x power n. Next, 1 minus x power n formula. 1 minus n c 1 into x plus n c 2 into x square plus etc. up to n c n minus 1 power n into x power n. Why we are taking minus 1 is here. Minus means alternative sign. So according to the number of term, this will decide whether it is plus or minus. Okay, so what we have seen now? Binomial theorem. What is binomial theorem? X plus a power n, one formula, and a term formula tr plus 1 equal to
ncr x power ncr x power n minus r a power r, correct? Next, finding middle terms. So if middle term, if we want to find out the middle term, we have two formulas. If n is even, one formula, n is odd, na another formula. And last formula is in the formula binomial theorem, if we substitute a equal to 1, so we have two formulas, 1 plus x power n and 1 minus x power n. We have two formulas, right? So this is what, using this we are going to do the problem. Shall we get into the exercise? So take your exercise 2.6. Exercise 2.6, first problem. I'll do third subdivision. The remaining subdivision is your homework. It's okay. Take your first problem, third subdivision. Expand the following by using binomial theorem. So we have to use binomial theorem to expand that. Expand, na? We have to simplify that. Okay, ma? Okay, what is the question? X plus 1 by x square the whole power 6. Okay, now what is the power here? It is 6. Is it possible to use a formula? No, because 6 we don't have formula. If we don't have formula, then what we can do? We can use the formula, correct? Now let's get into the solution. First we can write the formula, then it is easy to proceed. So what is the binomial formula? X plus a power n, correct? Okay, what is the formula? X power n plus n c 1 x power n minus 1 into a plus n c 2 x power n minus 2 into a 2 a square plus etc. Last term is a n. Okay, this is your formula. Is that okay? So we are going to use this formula to expand that. That's all. Okay, so shall we take the expression? Okay, here x plus 1 by x square the whole power 6, which is equal to, before that, what is your x term is x, what is your a term? 1 by x square. What is your n value? 6. Now you can substitute here, so this will become x power n. So x power 6 plus 6 c 1 x power 6 minus 1 is 5 into a value is 1 by x square plus n c 2 x power n minus 2. N minus 2 na 6 la 2 poch na 4, 1 by x square power 2. Now I'll tell you how to do this expansion easily. Okay, first we start up with x power 6, next enna vandirukku x power 5, next x power 4. Appo what will be the next term? X 3, x power 3, x power 2, x power 1, x power 0, correct? Okay, ipo this is your a term. Inga a oda power 1 irukku, so inga a power 1, inga a power 2. Appo edhu varaikkum pogum? A power 3, a power 4, a power 5, a power 6 varaikkum pogum. That's all. Okay, and idu 6c1 6c2 appadi continue line a vandute irukku. Okay, now can I proceed? Okay, this will be 6c3 x power 3 1 by x square whole power 3. Thirumba 6c4 x power 2 1 by x square the whole power 4. And next term will be 6c5 x into 1 by x power 5 plus 6c6 1 kapra 0, 5 kapram 6. Correct? Again, we have to simplify that. Now, x power 6, no need to do anything. So that one will be as it is, x power 6. Next, 6c1. What is the answer? 6. So adhu vandu 6 into x power 5 by x power 2. Next 6c1 mudichacha. Next 6c2. 6c2 eppadi calculate pannuvom? So 6c2 epdi calculate panuvom 6 into 5 by 1 into 2 1 2 is to 3 2 are 6 appo 5 3 are 15 the answer okay va so 6c2 oda answer enna 15 and anga balance enna irukku x power 4 by x power 4 nu irukku plus next enna 6c3 epdi find out panuvom 6 into 5 into 4 by 1 into 2 into 3 so cancel panninga 20 x power 3 by x power 6 okay va next 6c1 c2 c3 c4 epdi calculate panuvom 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 by 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 correct ah so neenga pottingina answer will be 15 x power 2 by x power 8 and here 6c5 oda answer 6 x by 5 2s are 10 na so x power 10 next plus 6c6 oda answer 1 anything power 0 1 so idu mattum da varum that is 1 by x power 12 correct ah now nama cancel pannumna this square and 5 pona 3 varum 4 4 will get cancel idha 3 inga pannumna balance will be 3 and idha cancel pannumna 2 pochna 6 and idha pochna 9 that's all so again if you rewrite what will be the answer x power 6 plus 6 x power 3 plus 15 plus 20 by x cube plus 15 by x power 6 plus 6 by x power 9 plus 1 by x power 12 that's all this is your final answer is that clear okay so that's all the remaining problems we can see it in the next class and your homework is exercise 2.6 first problem first subdivision and second subdivision and example two point three seven and 2.38 thank you students